Hi, this is Mike with 107 Designs. We're going to be talking about lens blur and depth of field in this screencast. This is a real quick way to throw some depth of field effect on a photograph that you have, but it comes with fair warning. I'm going to show you two samples. In the first one, we're going to come out with a pretty nice result. In the second one, I'm going to show you what things to look out for and avoid. You may have to work with some manual, you know, fixing things to make it not look fake. All right. So the first photograph we have is this. I just snapped these this morning, so, you know, don't make fun. I've got, I threw out some silverware on the table, I've got some knives and a fork in the middle. In this photograph, most of the things are in the same plane of focus. You can see that the knife in the foreground is kind of in the same focus as the knife in the background. And, you know, it just doesn't look good. Maybe I want to highlight this fork a little bit, right? So, how do we do that? We're going to make just a real quick couple of changes to this photograph, and it'll come out looking pretty nice. First thing we're going to do is go into our quick mask mode, which is the letter Q on the keyboard, where you press this button, all right? And then we're going to select the gradient tool, making sure that we have the reflected gradient selected and not the linear or any of the others, okay? So got the reflected gradient. What does a reflected gradient mean? It means that when you pull a gradient, you start from one point like the fork and you pull it out the other way, any gradient that you make is mirrored on the opposite side of your starting point, okay? So you probably know this already, but if you hold down the shift key while you're dragging a gradient, Photoshop will limit you to the nearest 45 degree angle. You can see that how it sort of locks in to the nearest 45. Which is helpful because this, we want this real linear straight line, right, from the fork out to the knives. I'm gonna pull this gradient from, let's say, the fork to, let's say about the, you know, between the second and the third knife in the background, okay? And I'm gonna let it go and you'll see what we end up with. We've got this depth of field setting that we're shooting for because this transparent area is around the fork and the table. You can see the wood grain and the fork, they're all kind of in the same plane. And then sort of this more opaque red setting where this mask is covering up the knives in the foreground and the background. Now the reason this photograph is going to work pretty well for us is because the knives and the fork are all in the same plane, nearly, you know, effectively, as the surface, okay? All of the background image in our shot is just the tabletop. So it's not that far away from the knives and the forks. So that's why this is gonna work. Take note of that for our next photograph. You'll see why this is, can be a hangup, okay? So now we're gonna get out of quick mask mode by clicking this button or pressing the Q again, it just jumps out of quick mask mode. Notice our selection's already made for us, okay? So we're gonna go up here to filter. Quickly we're going to choose blur. Lens blur is the one that we're shooting for. Let me drag this over into the screen here. Let's zoom in on this a little bit. I want to zoom in. I want to look at the knives in the foreground and the background, and I want to look at this fork and the table wood grain right here along there, along that plane. And that looks pretty good. Here's the setting that you can play with. If you're unhappy, depending on the size of your photo and the amount of blur that you want, is the radius setting, okay? Now, if I loosen this up, if I pull this down a little bit, you're gonna see that it's gonna, it makes it look a little bit more realistic by knocking down the radius a little bit. Going up to higher levels is pretty aggressive and can start to look fake pretty quickly. So just take note of that. I think I can get away with something about around here without looking too fake. I'm just gonna scan across this photo and take a look. Yeah, I'd be pretty happy with that. You know, it's obviously highlighting the fork more. There's a little bit of blur in the foreground and background, but it's not just bat you over the head, you know, fake. So I'm gonna go ahead and click OK, and you'll notice that applies the filter, and now I've got this nice, pretty nice photograph. I've got, you know, the fork is obviously highlighted and in focus, and the knives are not, and it doesn't look terribly fake. That's the first one. Now let's jump over to this other. Notice that in this, by the way, photograph that the that we're taking a shot where things are you know, sort of like the depth of field moves vertically through the photograph. This other one that we're going to look at, the depth of field moves horizontally through the photograph. Okay, I set up same table. Okay, I set up some martini glasses. Notice that in this one, the item closest to us is not on the bottom of the image. It's on the right side. So this time, when we make a blur, we're going to be blurring, say, from the middle or something like that, and we're going to be blurring toward one side and the other, left and right. Okay, but here's the hang up. Notice that the majority of the background in this photo is not in the same plane as these glasses are. Okay, in fact, it's pretty far away. I've got a wall back there, a piece of art on the wall, a chair, a window, and all that. So this could get pretty hairy. We're gonna try it anyway, and I'll show you why it looks kind of fake. Okay, so the same thing. We're gonna enter quick mask mode. All right, we're gonna select our gradient tool. And make sure that we get a reflected gradient. And then we're gonna pick this second glass, okay? And I'm just gonna pull out just a little bit from the second glass. Okay, now here's where you can really see why this is gonna look fake. In this transparent area, which is where our plane of focus is going to be, I've got this foreground of the table, which is obviously not even, you know, close to the same plane as the second glass. The glass stem itself, all right? Then all the way in the background, I've got part of the wall, I've got part of the artwork on the wall, and you know, then in the out of focus areas, I should have different amounts of out of focus for how far away something is. Like this window in the background is obviously more distant than the lip of this glass, all right? But effectively, the blur is going to be the same for both pieces in the photo, so it's going to look pretty fake. We're going to do it anyway, just to see. All right, we're going to get out of quick mask mode. Our selection's made. Then we're going to go into filter. We're going to blur, lens blur, and now let's take a look at this. All right, we zoom in. Okay. And I'm gonna bump up in this photograph. I'm gonna move the radius up to about 13 or so. I think we can get away with that. Okay. Here's the thing to notice. All right, if we cropped this real tightly around the glassware, all right, and then we manually sort of messed with the wall area and the table, we could probably get away with this. All right, but the really noticeable fake parts are going to be the artwork in the background, all right, and the table in the foreground. Okay, so just take note of that. If you have a photograph that you want to apply a little depth of field effect to, keep in mind that it could look fake pretty easily. We're going to go ahead and click OK. We'll see how this turns out, and then we're going to deselect that. Let's zoom in a little bit and see what we have, okay? You can see what I was talking about right here, okay? Right here, we got this straight up and down plane of focus, and everything else is out of focus. It just doesn't look real. You know, it doesn't look good. In fact, in the same plane of the stem of the glass, we've got this edge of the glass that's right in front of our face, which this whole glass should be out of focus. Okay, so this is a case where you'd want to make several layers and sort of, you know, chop some stuff away and manually blur some things that are obvious mistakes, and then layer them on top of each other. It can be quite a lot of work to make it look realistic, but that's really what you'd have to do to fake depth of field in a photograph like this. Okay, so anyway, I hope this helps someone out, and you know, join us again next Saturday for another screencast, and we'll talk to you later on. Bye-bye.